Hi everyone, so today we are going to end this chemical kinetics by last video. So that is what the methods of determination of order of the reaction. This is the last video from this chemical kinetics. If you want any other topic, you can mention in the comment section. So I will do. So most of my students are mentioning that they want basics of organic chemistry. So I am thinking about it. So definitely. So I will do that one. So based on the comments, based on the number of comments, I can do that concept. Okay, na? So first we are going to see the what methods of determination of order of the reaction. What are the different experimental methods we have to determine order of the reaction? We have the what mainly four methods are there. First one is integrated method, or it is also called hit and trial method. It is also called trial and error method. Second method is what half-life method. Fourth one is Wontoff differential method. So third one is Wontoff differential method. Fourth one is Ostwald's isolation method. One by one we are going to see. First integrated method. So it is also called what hit and trial method or trial and error. What is mean by trial and error? So if you once try for the what success, then only you will know whether you are getting or not. Without trying, I won't. I cannot, I can't. If you are saying like that, you may not get the good rank in an good IITs, IIT, IITM colleges, is it or not? If you want to qualify mains, and if you are going for the what advanced exam also, then you have to try no first. So then only you can know whether it is possible or not. In first stage, this year they are conducting four stages. So it may be continued for the next year also, maybe. So you have four trials. You have to succeed. It may be what in any one stage you will succeed. That definitely, it is no doubt at all. Okay, na? So once we will see the what trial and error method, it is also called integral method, hit and trial method. What is there here? Nothing but whatever the integral form of rate equation we know. So whatever the data they given experimentally, that we have to substitute in that integral form. And we have to check that whether that integrate, that is what rate constant of that order reaction is remains constant or not. Because rate constant of reaction is independent on the concentration and time. It is only depends on the what temperature. That we need to see. Okay, na? So now here what first we will check for with the what zero order, K0. That is K0 is what here A minus X by T. Now initial concentration you consider first 1 and 2. That is 16 is the what initial concentration, final one will be what 8. Initial time, final time, that is a difference in the time we have to take. K0 is equal to what 16 minus 8 by 5. That is 16 minus 8, that is what 8, 8 by 5. Keep it as it is, no need of doing calculation. So it is a first from 1 and 2. From 1 and 2. Now from 2 and 3 we will do. Or from 1 and 3 we will do. From 1 and 3. If K0 is equal to 1 and 3. That is what initial concentration 16. Final concentration is 4. By time change is what 0 to 10. That is 10. That is what 16 minus 4 is 12. 12 by 10. That is nothing but what 6 by 5. So are we getting 8 by 5 here? No. The rate constants are in the first experimental. It is first try. It is second try. First try of rate constant is not equal to second one, then it is not zero order. Then go for the first order checking. So hit and trial, we are substituting and we are checking. So next is what K1. K1 is equal to what 2.303 by T log of A by A minus X. In this case, initial concentration we have to substitute from 1 and 2. From 1 and 2 we are same. So then what happens? K1 of first trial, that is 2.303 by change in time is what to 5. Log of A is what to 16 by final is what to 8. 8 2 is the 16. Log 2 into 2.303 into log 2 by 5. You keep it as it is. Don't do calculation anything. Just we will get the what to. Next from 1 and 3. Not only these, you can take the what any one of the four experimental values. Any two you can take and you can check. So that is what K1 of second trial, that is 2.303 by
Here what happens, 1 and 3 we are checking, that is 16 minus 4, what time will be 10, that is log of initial concentration is 16, final is what to 4, then what happens here, 4 4 sir, 16, then what happens, 2.303, log 4 can be written as what, log 2 power 2 by 10, so can we write like this, 2.303 into 2 log 2 by 10, because log of x power n form, n into log x we can write it as 2 5 10, then we can get the what, 2.303 by 5 log 2, do we got or not, same value or not, that is what k1 of first trial is equal to k2 of, k1 of second trial, that is what it is, rate constant is equal, so it is a first order reaction, is that clear? So differential method, first method is clear, just a hit and trial method we have to do, just formula substitution and checking. Next, coming to the half-life, which is very very important for mains level. So now we are going to see the what half-life method. In this half-life, we know that what the time required to consume half of the initial concentration. In the those who not watched the previous videos, half-life, you can see there, you will find the what definition. For nth order reaction, T half is what, it is inversely proportional to concentration of reactant power n minus 1. Initial concentration power n minus 1. So from this what we can say here, T half of first one by T half of second one is equal to A2 by A1. Can we write like this? A2 by A1 power n minus 1. Okay na? So from this what we can write here? T half of first one will be, is directly proportional to a power n minus 1, that is T half of second one condition will be what, inversely proportional to a 2 power n minus 1. If you are doing the ratio, then we are getting that one. Apply both sides logarithm, log of T half of first condition by T half of second condition is equal to, it is log of a power n form, n into log a we can write it as n minus 1 into log of a 2 by a 1. We can write. So from this n minus 1 is equal to, n minus 1 is equal to this log, it is multiplying here, it will come in this side, it will be denominator. T half of 1 by T half of 2, second experimental condition, it is what, to log of A2 by A1. So from this n is equal to what happens, 1 plus log of T half of first experimental condition by T half of second experimental condition by log of A2 by A1, A2 by A1. Now this is what formula to calculate the order of the reaction. N is what here? Order of the reaction. If they are given experimentally T1, that is T half values and initial concentration. So you substitute those and you calculate the what order of the reaction. We'll have the what problem based on this. We'll discuss that one at the end of the video. You try to listen, try to watch till the end of the video. In the middle also, I am posting the what related problems for the method. Now next is, here one more important concept is there. That is what, here in this half-life only, if they are not given the what initial concentration, that is reactant and half-life, if they not mentioned, just they mention the what angle. So they are giving the what in graphical method. Okay, then what we have to do? In that case, how to calculate the order of the reaction? Say for example, second method in that half-life, second method, that is T half is what we know, that is A power N minus 1 we know. From this T half is equal to what, to V by A power N minus 1. Is it or not? So from this you apply the logarithm on both sides, log of T half is equal to log B, log of b by a power n minus 1, log of a by b, it is log a minus log b, we have to write log b plus log of a power n minus 1, we have to do log of t half is equal to log b plus log of a power n minus 1. So from that log of a n minus 1 will come front, log of t half is equal to n minus 1 log a plus log b. Can we write like this? How it is? Y is equal to mx plus c. Then plot a graph between what? Log of t half On y-axis we had taken log of A, initial concentration on x-axis. Then what happens? It is y equal to mx plus c by making some intercept. That is A is equal to log B. So here what is the slope here? What is the slope? Slope is equal to, that is m is equal to n minus 1. Now if the slope is not given, if they had given the what angle. So here angle theta they given. Then what happens? We know that what slope is equal to, slope m is equal to what we know? Tan theta. So is it or not? Slope m is equal to n minus 1, slope m is equal to tan theta. Then tan theta is equal to n minus 1. So then n is equal to what happens? N is equal to, so that is, you can write it as what? 1 plus tan theta. 1 plus tan theta. Is that clear? So for example, if theta is taken is what here? If theta is 45 degrees, if theta is 45 degrees, then what is the order of the reaction? 1 plus tan 45 is what? 1. Tan 45, that is 1 plus 1, that is second order. It is what? Which order reaction? For second order reaction. For second order reaction, what happens? For second order reaction, in this case, what happens? For second order reaction, here, what happens? Tan theta is equal to, n is equal to 1 minus tan theta, it will be. N is equal to, what happens? 1 minus tan theta. N is equal to 1 minus tan theta. Okay, na? So then what happens here? Whenever we are substituting in this case minus, here minus, then what happens? We becomes what? 0. Okay, na? Sorry. Now in this case what happens? The half-life and initial concentrations, how they are directly related. So half-life increases with initial concentration. Is that clear? Next we are taking the water, one more graph. So here what happens when we are taking the water, log T half versus log A. Here what is the order of the reaction? For this is they are saying. So in this case the slope will be water. Here slope is equal to 1 minus tan theta. Okay, now in this case theta will be what? For this theta will be either it may be 0 degrees or it may be 180 degrees. Is it or not? So 180 degrees. Then what happened? N is equal to 1 minus tan 0 is what? 0. That is 1. N is equal to what? It is a first order reaction. So for first order reaction, T half is what? Is constant. Is it or not? So T half does not depend on the initial concentration. T half is remains constant whatever the initial concentration is changing. We can take the one more graph also, log of T half versus log A. Now it is, if you are getting log like this, then what happens? In this case, now theta will be what? Say for example, theta is what? Minus 45 degrees. Then order is equal to what happens? 1 minus tan theta. That is 1 minus tan minus 45. That is nothing but what? 1 plus 1. That is 2. Tan minus will multiply here, minus into minus plus, tan 45 is 1, that is 2. It is what? Second order reaction. So that is what? Order is what? Half-life is inversely proportional to initial concentration. That is negative slope we are getting. Is that clear? So that is what? Half-life method, very very important half-life method. So next we are going to see the what? Wanthoff differential method. Next we are going to see the Wanthoff differential method. Wanthoff differential method is, that is a third step. Wanthoff's differential method. Now in this case what happens? We know that what for a reaction A gives rise to product. So say for example it is a nth order reaction. So rate of decomposition or rate of disappearance of this reactant is equal to K into concentration of reactant power N. Is it or not? It is in differential form. Wanthoff differential method they are saying. So it is nothing but what rate. So rate is equal to k into a power n. So I am taking the rate as what r, just simply r is equal to k into concentration of reactant power n I am considering. So in this case r1 by r2 is equal to that is rate of it is initial concentration a only you keep. So r1 by r2 is equal to that is rate 1 by rate 2 is equal to that is what happens concentration of a1 reactant by concentration of a2 reactant whole power n. Apply the both sides logarithm. So log of r1 by r2 is equal to log of a power n, it is n into log a, we can write n into log of first reactant concentration into second reactant concentration. So from this n is equal to what order of the reaction, that is log of r1 by r2 first rate by second rate, after that log of so a1 by a2. If they had given in the experimental values initial concentration and rate, that is concentration of reactant and rate they given, then we have to use this formula to calculate the water order of the reaction. Is that clear? So next we are going to see the water Ostwald's isolation method. In this Ostwald's isolation method, so this Wantoff differential method is used, only one reactant is present. Only one reactant is present here, only one reactant. Only one reactant is present, then we have to use this Wantoff differential method. So Ostwald isolation method, when we have to use Ostwald's isolation method. So in case of Ostwald's isolation method, we have to use the water here more than one reactant is there. Say for example three reactants are there, A plus B plus C gives rise to product. But what happens here, only one reactant is taken in limited quantity. Remaining all reactants are, except one reactant, remaining reactants are taken in excess quantity. So then what happens? Rate is equal to k into concentration of A into B into C. Okay. So then what happens? It is power n, it is power 0, it is power 0. Because here order with respect to limiting reactant, that is A, will be what? N. We don't know whether it is, how much it is, order it is. So order with respect to that is B is what? 0, because it is an excess reactant. So rate of reaction does not depend on the excess reactant. Order with respect to C, then what happens? Because it is also excess. So that is what in Ostwald isolation method, one reactant will be taken in what a limited quantity. Remaining all reactants are taken in what a excess quantity. Then we will calculate the what order of the reaction. So based on the excess reactant and limiting reactant measurement. Is that clear? So I hope so. You have understood. Next we will see some problems on this. See this one. Here what they given, relation between what the values they given, initial concentration and half-life. What they are asking to find? Order of the reaction. When they given initial concentration and half-life, for simple calculation I had taken two values, but in the experiment, in the question, you will get the more than two also, or two values also. Now you can take the what order formula will be what 1 plus log of t half of first condition by t half of second condition by log of a2 by a1. Already we had derived this formula from half-life method. Okay, so n is equal to 1 plus log of t half of first one will be what 100, second one will be what 200, that is 100 by 200 is nothing but what log of 1 by 2, it becomes, it is what log of a2 is how much 20, a1 is what 10, so log 2 it is. Now you can write it as what n is equal to 1 plus 2 power minus 1, that can be written here 2 power minus 1 we can write, that minus 1 will come front, so that is plus of minus 1 into log 2 by log 2 here, log 2 get cancelled, that is 1 minus 1, that is equal to 0. Is that clear? Now
by seeing this graphical, by seeing this values also we can say. Now you see here, initial concentration is doubled, half-life is also doubled. Initial concentration is doubled, half-life is also doubled. In which case that is, half-life is directly proportional to A in case of zero order. So it is an, by using formula we can do, or else by studying the values also we can say. Initial concentration is doubled, half-life is also doubled, that is what a zero order reaction. Is that clear? Very important. So similarly for this reaction, it is somewhat difficult to predict. So we have to use the formula N is equal to 1 plus log of T half of first one by T half of second one. That is log of 100 by 25. Antena? So that is what, is that correct? That is 100 by 25. Log of 20 by 10, A2 by A1. So log 2 it is what, log 4 can be written as 1 plus log 4 can be written as 2 log 2 by log 2. Log 2 get cancelled, it is 1 plus 2, that is third order reaction. Is that clear? So in case of third order reaction what happens, T half is inversely proportional to square of initial concentration. That is T half is inversely proportional to square of initial concentration. How we got, sir, that one? So we know that what, T half is directly proportional to A power N minus 1. 3 you substitute 3 minus 1, that is 3 A square. Is that clear? So now from that we got, now you see here, T half is double, initial concentration is double. Then what happens, half-life will be decreases by how many times a square of its time? Okay, that is decreases by 4 times it is. Okay, it is doubled means it will be decreases by 4 times. It is 4 times means it is decreased by 16 times, like that. So that is what in case of third order reaction. In this case, now simply by seeing this, we can predict half-life is constant. That is what first order. Is that clear? So in which case the half-life will be remains the same here. That is T half is equal to remains constant. Remains constant. So it is in first order. No need of doing the calculation also. Now next, coming to the graphical method, which is very important. For zero order reaction we'll see. So by the definition they are giving the what, rate versus time. Rate is independent on the time, as well as rate is independent on the concentration of reactant. So these are what, based on rate. Now you can take the what, x versus t. So what you have to do when they given like that, so you have to take the what, x on y axis and t on x axis. To get that one, first we need to take the what, integrated form, k is equal to x by t. So from that, x is equal to what happens, k0 into t for zero order. So it is y is equal to mx. Is that or not? We have to convert like that whenever the given x versus t, x and t involved in zero order. So we have to convert like that. Then it is easy to find the slope. Slope is equal to what? Slope is equal to m, that is m is equal to k0 in case of zero order. Now in this case, it is what here? What is the slope? It is also zero order only. Zero order and first order graphs are very important. Now we have the what, k0 is equal to a minus x by t. Is it or not? So from this k0 is equal to, k0 into t is equal to a minus x. So a minus x is present on y axis. So a minus x should be taken this side, a minus x. This plus k0 t can be taken this side, minus k0 into t plus a. Now it is, how it is? Y is equal to mx plus c. So on x-axis we have time, on y-axis a minus x. So on c is what here, c is intercept a. So slope m is equal to what, minus k0. Is that clear? Very very important. So I think so it is clear. So I am arising for the calculation of first order part. So try to make a notes of it. So it is very useful for further revision purpose. Okay, na? So whatever, when you are doing the noting, so just you pause the video and you note down. Now first order, you see, in case of first order, rate versus a minus x. We know that what, in case of first order, rate is directly proportional to
concentration of reactant power 1, that is directly proportional. So we are getting like this only. Now in this case, log of A minus X versus T. Okay, now. Now you take the water of K1 is equal to 2.303 by T log of A by A minus X. So from this what happens? K1 T by 2.303 can be written as log of A minus log of A minus X. I am dividing that what to, I am separating into log A by B form, log A minus log B. So from that I want the what Y axis on log A minus X. That minus log A minus X I am taking this side. It becomes what to plus log of A minus X is equal to this plus value I am taking this side minus K1 by 2.303 into T plus log A. So how it is Y is equal to MX plus C form. Okay na? So on Y axis what we have taken log of A minus X. So C is what there? Intercept C is equal to log A. So slope is what to? M is equal to minus K1 by 2.303. Is that clear? Very, very important. So in that manner, half life, each and every graph I had given at the explanation part itself only. Now you can see here. So here what are initial concentration of reactant versus time we had taken. We are getting the graphs like this exponentially. The concentration of reactant exponentially decreases with time. Rate is also decreases exponentially with the time. Then what happens right here? This is a first order graph, second order, third order graph. So which graph, which order of the graph will have more slope? So in that case, slope of first order will be more when compared to slope of second order, then after slope of third order. This is what total chemical kinetics. I am not sure, I have given the word 100% subject. So I had given you 95% subject. If you learn this 95% subject, definitely it will be useful for you. So in that, no doubt at all. So maximum, so for the mains and the NEET level, it is sufficient. Okay, na? So try to make a note of it and do more number of, practice more number of objective questions. Okay, na? Thank you. Have a nice day. Those who till not subscribed, you can subscribe once and like it. Thank you.